Hello and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, a Tear of Vermillion blind Amethyst Lunatari, now entering Golda Cave to hopefully find the missing Meefas. Standard cave music. An animal's voice says, "Meow." I'm guessing that's what they sound like. "Meow, meow." "It's them," says Archim. Avon says, "I knew they would be hiding here." "Oh, that's because her grandfather told you." "They are here," Miles says. "Even though it's so humid in here, I can still smell the Meefa scent." "But something is wrong," says Archim. "They sounded scared." Avon says, "Let's search every inch of the cave." "Let's." "Oh! Let's kill every inch of these monsters." What is it? Mestis? Because of other slacers, we found those before. And I got a mess this. Well, these two. Fight that. And those two fight that. Oh, I love the song. Especially this part. Whoa! Not too bad. Archim levels up! Yay, Archim! Level 12, she got Magic Shield. Avon levels up and got Electro Cube. Mile levels up, got Freeze Throw. And Douglas, maybe next time. That's pretty awesome. Electro Cube, a spell to summon lightning, damaging all nearby enemies. I actually want to try that out. And then who else got Mile? Magic Shield? Oh, he had that already. Archim just got that. It's a skill? Oh, Freeze Throw. Boomerang move that aims at the feet of an enemy, stopping the enemy's movement. Sweet. Oh, Steel Throw. We can steal stuff from them. Actually, I haven't tried that. Actually, I did try it way back at the beginning against the, I stole something from the Hammerhatches, the first one we ever fought. We thought it was a named boss monster. North or west? Let's go west. Thin blood bat? Well, at least it's thin. Should be easier to kill than the thick variety. What is the... Is the blood bat thin? Or is the blood in the bat thin? We must know these things. Alright, these things are pretty tough. Ah, next time, Douglas. We get level 15. He's still ahead of them. This way. There's the monster down there. Meefas! Where are you, little stinkers? So that leads to another area. No, I can't avoid them all. There's a chest there. Yay! almost sounds like a guitar playing. No, she just gets right up and starts attacking. Oh wait, no, he was... I thought he was running... never mind. I meant for Douglas to stay where he was, and for the three of them to stay where they were. Never mind. Douglas levels up. Level 15. Hold on, let me just see what's in here. A Rattle Bash? What's that? That sounds like some kind of, weapon? Oh yeah. Single-handed sword as powerful as a two-handed one. Skill needed to use. Oh. I wonder if we need some kind of skill, like later on it could give us a better attack than what it is now. Or maybe only... maybe it would only help with Douglas wielding it. No, still doesn't seem as good as the greatsword. And she can only use blunt weapons, apparently. Alright, come on. Gotta love these finishing moves. Healing. Nice. 500 rose. Or roses. Monster's owner a tail. Got lost in here. Oh, good. Oh, yeah. SP Arcanum 2, whatever this SP is. Special. The third area. Just want to make sure. Those are the dead end. I think that's what I was thinking of. Oh, I want to see what's up north there. North. West. I'll wait till there's a lot of monsters to use her sleep finishing move. they do that. I think I saw them do that once. Just before. That's what you get for doing that. No, there was nothing down there but that monster. Okay, so let's go up to the third screen. But you know, there is another screen that I didn't get to right off the first area, not going north, we didn't take. Are these things buried this deep in the cave? Okay, I got north and southwest. Now we got all these blood bats. Whoops. Got three of us that time. Okay. Ava needs help. Let's do rarer. Okay, that healed him from 22 all the way up to 107. Let me throw a save here. Trying to eliminate some areas here. Oh. Is that all that is? Oh. Never mind. Nothing here. Meefas! Where are you? Douglas says, Avon says, Douglas, what's wrong? I feel a disturbance in the force. There's the Meefas. Oh, hunted by monsters. Look at those shaggy white things. Mew, mew. Mew, mew, mew. Wait, says Avon. Please stay away from them, says Archim. Avon says, you're gonna pay for this. Look at their monsters. You can't reason with them. Tell them they're gonna pay. Big beaten. Well, thanks, Pat. Or Katie. Alright. Avon will go for B. We'll do a big beat in A. Douglas will also go for B. And then Archim will try to put him to sleep. One down. That one's still kicking, look at that. Oh, missed one of them. Energy bullet. Is that one sleeping? No, just this. Oh no, they're both sleeping. I see the Z is over that one's head, but blocking the other one. You know what I mean? You know what I mean. So let's just attack the one, obviously, that's still awake. Zero. Any blunt weapons are no good on it. Zero again. Wow, this thing's tough. Alright, Mile, I hope these things keep sleeping. A rarer on even. And she has zero effect on it. That's a skill. You know what? Alright, have him attack. That. And since she has zero effect on it, she can heal even. She has more magic points than him right now, anyway. Oh, we got it. Holy light, give your healing. Alright. Oh, we woke that thing up. Oh, put it back to sleep with the boomerang. Sweet. Oh, and then woke it back up again. Oh, stone blast. Ah. Let's get rid of the blood bat thing. I think this heals all, but I can't get a description, I forget. Just a rare on Archim then. And a rare on... Actually, a rarer on Douglas. Nice, you just got this one left. Nice. I gotta remember to heal her, well, and the others. Yay, level up. Level 13. Archim, you have caught up to, well, most of us. We got hermit boots. Douglas says, I think they're gone. Well, yeah, you killed them. We killed them. Archim says, is everyone okay? Mune! You must have been scared. You're safe now. Mune, mune, mune. Douglas says, wow, you scared me. Hey, it's tickling, says Mile. Avon says, they're so full of energy. Archim chuckles. It's their way of saying thank you. I guess they like you. That's good, says Avon. Meefas, please listen. I want you to return to the forest with us. The people of Newborn will be in trouble if you don't come. I'll make the townspeople promise they'll never treat you like that again. So come back with us to the forest, please. Mion Mion? Yeah, I figured I would say something like that. Really? Oh, there they go. What did they say, Archim? Says Avon. Mile asks, did the Meefas go back to the forest? Well, they will go straight to Newborin and purify the polluted air. Wow. I hope the people of Newborin don't attack them and try to take their fur. What? Says Avon. Oh, and I wasn't done in... Can I just explore more of the dungeon? There's a way I didn't go. That's pretty awesome, though. Ah, we came back. I wasn't done in there. Avon says, air has returned to normal. It was so polluted just now. I can't believe it. Miles says, not only is the air clean, but it smells good, too. That's a nice bonus. Mew. Archim says, thank you. You did good. So the problem is solved, says Douglas. The townspeople won't hunt the Meefas again, not after they find out that these animals saved their lives. Well, you're betting on them being intelligent. You never know. Miles says, even if the townspeople understand how important the Meefas are, I doubt the Great Oracle will give up hunting them. We must stop this evil at its source. Avon says, to close the case for good, let's go to the monastery and tell Great Oracle Avarice what really happened. That should convince him to stop the Meefa hunt immediately. Let me guess, they're not going to go back. Let us go back to the cave. Archim says, this time I will use everything I have to persuade him. Not only for the Meefas, but for all living things that live on this land. Mew. Damn it. Let's visit the Grand Oracle. I hope I didn't miss anything good in that dungeon. Meefas are really great. I've recovered completely. Now that I feel better, I must decide on what kind of store I'll open. I rented this place to open a store. What do you think I should sell? Accessory, toy shop, lunch shop, no idea. Well, there's already an accessory shop. And there's already a cafeteria, so how about a toy shop? Yes, yes. I was also thinking about that, too. Customers won't come if the store has no originality. They may not be useful, but I'm going to sell some fun stuff. I'll have fun selling them, too. I'll think about what merchandise to carry after cleaning up the store. I'm so motivated. Yeah, buddy! You guys doing better? It's amazing, Hunter Rob says. I didn't know Meefas had such power. Meefas may be messengers of spirits. I promise on the spirits in the forest I will never hunt them again. I didn't know Meefas were so cute. They make me want to hug them. Hug them, I tell you. Let's see, he doesn't say anything right. I still don't know if she's gonna stay with us. Mew, mew, mew. Archim says, oh, you must be hungry. Okay, okay. Archim took out cookies from her pocket. Mew. It's delicious, isn't it? You just carry around cookies like that? Oh. No, I don't need a stimulant. How about some cookies? Shannon seems alright. She is sound asleep now. I see, says Mile. Thank you very much. We were saved by these little ones. I'm giving them milk as a way of saying thank you. Oh, we got milk and we got cookies. Do you know what they eat? Their favorites are fruit and bread, says Archim. They also love whipped cream. Fruit, bread, and whipped cream. Yes, I think they'll love it. What are you making? Mile says. It's a secret. Wait until it's ready. Hi, Mile. Shannon seems to be okay now. Please go and see her. Oh, all right. All right. Grin and bear it, Mile. She's steeping. Oh, Mile. No, please don't. Sleeping soundly. Avon says, what kind of dream is she seeing? Let's go quickly, says Mile. Okay. I feel ashamed of myself. We were hunting Meefas like mad, but they saved our lives. Archim says, Meefas love humans. No matter how much they are mistreated by humans, Meefas never hate us. They become attached to us instead. That's why I can't stop loving them. Can I be a friend of Meefas after all I did? Of course. Let's see if this guy will recant his ways. He's the one who said he wouldn't stop hunting. So, hunting Meefa's dirty's heir. But I can't find any other job as easy and lucrative. To hunt or not to hunt? That is the question. Archim says, well, it's not the question you should brood over. Archim looked down sadly. Yeah, right. Is that like a yeah, right? Or like, yeah, right? I think health is the most important thing. I'm glad you understand. I don't know. I didn't know Meefa saved newborn. I'm really glad we solved the problem before it was too late. Oh, you are the girl who brought Meefas here. You're a goddess. May I worship you a little? Well, I guess it's okay. Great, thank you. Thank you for your grace and mercy. May I worship you a little? I feel full of energy after worshiping a pretty girl like you. Oh, brother. My lungs are filled with refreshing air. Douglas, I owe you one. Owe me one? Oh, because I brought Meefas? Then you should thank Archim, not me. Oh, so you were the one. Thank you. I didn't do anything. Please, thank the Meefas. Meefas love humans. They'll be happy if you treat them nice. Okay, I'll do that. But I want to thank you too, anyway. I couldn't do anything when the town was agonized by poisonous gas. I still have a long way to go to become a first-class adventurer. Yeah, you might have a long way to go. Hey, what's up? Oh, somebody stop me, says Mile. Oh, it's Geomane. Well, well, Mile. Nice to see you again. Avon says, you're not with him. That means he escaped again? Yes. Please listen. I caught him in Newborn, but he ran away again. He is a writer, so he knows tons of ways and tricks to disappear. I locked him in the inn tavern and kept watching, but before I knew it, he was gone. You can't go away around locking people in places. He has endless ideas about how to escape. I wish the same is true with his writing. By the way, who are they? Avon says, Douglas and Archim. They're traveling with us. I see. I'm Geomane. Nice to meet you, especially you, hunk. Douglas says, well, Miles says, so Douglas has his weakness after all. Anyway, Avon, if you find him, could you give him some ideas? Honestly, I'm troubled by him. I'll make up to you, I promise. So could you do that for me, please? Oh, I almost forgot. As I promised, this is for you. Quick Raven, Volume 1. Read it if you like. I'm sure it will sell millions. Cool. Avon and Company obtained Quick Raven 1. Sweet. I gotta write that down. I hope I didn't miss Swordmaster Volume 4 in that cave. Alright, so... I wrote it down, baby. I can't believe this. Where is he gone? Please take care of him, will you? Not about this. Quick Raven 1. What's it say? Exciting new novel by Karamuro Karamuzu. Volume 1, Wandering with Wind. I guess I'll read it really quick. I don't want to read 3. I didn't read 3 yet because I didn't find 2. Quick Raven Volume 1, Wandering with the Wind, Karamuro Karamas. It was a request from the king. The secret ancient book passed down through the royal family was stolen by thieves. The king wanted it back. The two young men who were asked of this task looked at each other. It might be a big deal that an item that belonged to the king was stolen. But if the thief is just a typical thief, it's not a very hard task to catch them. What do you want to do, Marl? A young adventurer named Raven asked his partner. The childhood friend with a calm face was smiling as if seeing what his partner would say. A strong breeze blew between them, but neither of them moved. We're going, right? Raven asked. Marl looked into the wind. It's better to face the storm, he said, and turned around. Treasures are always hidden in difficult places, Raven laughed. Ah, I could smell the storm. I wonder what's written on the ancient book that has been passed down through the royal family. Marl asked Raven, who was walking ahead. They were on a wild path that strayed from the main road. A cavern where thieves lived in was just ahead. I wonder why the thieves wanted it, and I can't believe that it would be just any old book if he asked adventurers for help. The two climbed a steep mountain without losing their breaths. The young adventurers walked faster, gleams of curiosity in their eyes. They get to the destination cavern before they even knew it. The two sneaked into the cavern as if melting into the darkness. But they didn't quite notice the pair of eyes watching the two of them. The cold cavern air tossed Raven's unkempt hair from side to side. Through his bangs in front of his face, Raven saw a light ahead and signaled his partner to move ahead toward the light, walking quietly. Interesting. Okay. Mune. See, I already gave the author ideas before that, so... I don't know if we have to tell him again. It's amazing! I didn't know Meefas had such power! No wonder the church banned the hunt. Feeling better? Mune? The air in the room has been cleaned thanks to the Meefa. You did good. Kukri tickled the Meefa's throat. Mune, making sound in the throat. We can't hunt such lovely animals. We must persuade the townspeople to stop the practice. The pain in my throat goes away when I'm holding this little one. Oh, I love you. Chitta squeezed the Meefa. Mune, floundering. Meefa, you're so cute. Give it a name or something. That's like saying, cat, you're so cute. Mew? Yes. I agree. Feeling better, Mayor? Oh, Aven. Ever since Meefas came, the fog has disappeared and we feel better now. We learned from this incident why the Meefa is called a sacred animal. However, Meefa Hunt is encouraged by the Order of the Great Oracle. An Order of the Great Oracle is an intent of the Holy Capital. What should we do? Aven says we wanted to talk to you about it. Aven and the company told the mayor about their plan to appeal to the Great Oracle about it. I see. Our town cannot continue hunting Meefas. If we tell the Great Oracle how much pain and anguish it has caused the residents, he may reconsider his decision. After all, it is the duty of the church to save people. I also ask you to appeal to the Great Oracle. Well, that's what we plan on doing, buddy. My headache is completely gone. I should get back to my work that's been piling up. I guess we're ready to continue on. Well, that's not the way out. Gotta head back to the monastery and confront the Oracle Avarice once again. That'll be next time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.